Well, hello everybody, this is Nikki Zick from Nikki Zick Paints, and good morning. Actually, it's 5:45 where I'm broadcasting from, and I had this wild idea this morning while having my coffee, still about the cat's tongue brush, but doing a minimalist gift card. And here I am, it's not really a gift card, it's a postcard, but just by using the cat's tongue brush in three different sizes, in three different colors. What a wonderful, I think, card that is. So it takes a little patience because you have to wait for each color to dry so that there's no bleeding, as you can see closely. Everything was dry. I first did the large pinwheel using my largest cat's tongue brush, a number 10 for the largest. Then I used a number 6 for the medium size. And then I went all the way down to number 2 for the smallest. So, and as you can also hear, I'm listening to some nice smooth jazz. So as I was doing each pinwheel, it's, as you see, the movement is really nice and graceful because I was doing it to the sound of the music. So I'm just going to start off with the large circle because, like I said, we need time for the others to dry. But as you can see, all you do is just overlap slightly. The middle I overlap more, and then the smallest I just did in the corner. And it has this graceful composition of a beautiful 5x7 card. I have envelopes that I sell bunches of 10 cards, 10 envelopes, on my Etsy shop, Fresh Paint at Nikki Z. But this has nothing to do with that. This is just my own personal card that I'm going to give to someone special. So let's get to painting. So I'm going to prop this up over here, just so you could look at it and I could look at it while I paint. And I'm going to do it in the same colors because, of course, I did them in pink and purple. My favorite. Let's start with my Relax Rock. Come on, Relax, help out. Okay, this brush, I never used it before. It's quite large. And I was wondering how I was going to fit it in my little pans over here, but it worked. And as you can see, I wet my brush first and then went right into the light pink. And you just load up your brush and make sure you load it well. And actually, you don't even want to load it too much because the paint absorbs into the bristles of the brush. So you dab off. And now I start into the center, upper, middle to upper left corner. So I start in the center, gradually go around, and I was turning my brush and down and lift, turn and down and lift, lift. Then I load more paint, went into backwards, you hear the nice music in the background, and just go with the tone. Paint's getting a little dry. Load up some more paint. Go back. Go tend on the edge. If you want to make it even larger, I need more paint. If I want to go even larger, this piece. Down. Up a little orange in my pan because, like I said, this brush is large. Go back. Okay, I think that's good for this large pinwheel. And then I'll make a part 2 and then go into the small second size, whoops, using my number 6 brush. I'm going to do the hot pink pinwheel. So I'm going to take a break now, drink a sip of coffee, and we'll come back and we'll do the second size middle pinwheel. Thank you. Hello, and we're back. This is Nikki Zick from Nikki Zick Paints, and we're doing a minimal postcard using two shades of pink and a purple accent. So the last video we did the large pink, pale pink pinwheel in the back, and now I had to let it dry because this is wet on dry. This pinwheel is dry. Has to be completely dry in order to do the next and then the last. So we're going to use the first pinwheel. Let's recap. For this pinwheel, I use a number 10 cat's tongue brush. For the next pinwheel, I'm going to be using a smaller size, a number 6. Okay? And for the number 6, we're going to go into my favorite color in the whole world. It'll never be beat. It's hot pink. So we're going to get it nice and wet and to a nice consistency in the pen and on the brush. Not too much on the brush because we will be re-dipping into our paint. So start in the outer edge of the pinwheel, and we're going to be listening to some jazz music. I'm doing this painting in the morning where I'm broadcasting. I'm on a commercial right now. We're listening to Pandora. But where I'm listening and broadcasting is early in the morning. It's about 6 a.m. and I started this at 5:45, so it's quite early, and I just love painting in the morning. So here we go with the second pinwheel. Like I said, there's commercials right now, as she just said right now. So I'll just talk over it. It's a commercial. I love commercials. No, I'm just joking. That's why I don't watch TV. So as you see, we're just going around and around as we do with the other videos and the cat's tongue brush. Pressing and lifting. Lifting for thin. Pressing for thick. Lifting for thin. Pressing for thick. And then reloading your brush. Oh, now we have the jazz music. Excellent. Perfect timing as we go around the last row of hot pink for the postcard. And we'll just have it come back around on itself, the circle. Okay, so now we have to let this medium circle dry, and then we'll have part 3 where I'll add the deep violet. So I'll be back in a few, and I'll see you then. Bye-bye. Hello, once again, this is Nikki Zick from Nikki Zick Paints, and this morning we're doing a minimal pinwheel gift greeting card, postcard, and this is what it looks like. And so far, it's a wet on dry technique, so we had to wait the first layer to dry, then we did the second layer of hot pink, and it's dry. And now we're going to do the last pinwheel in this deep violet using, and also the whole idea was using 3 different sizes of the cat's tongue brush. But for this last small pinwheel, we're using a size 2 cat's tongue brush. So going into the deep violet, make sure it's a nice thin consistency with the bristles. And you don't want too much at the beginning because it'll make a big blob of paint. And we start off center, and I'm listening to some jazz music. I'm going to be quiet as I go around the pinwheel and just focus on the music and my pinwheel. Here we go. You see? let it go back on itself. And there you have it. Three sizes. Cat's tongue brush, a size 10 for the large, a size 6 for the middle, and then a size 2 for the small. And I think it's a lovely minimal. You can do this with any color, and it could be a lovely card for anyone, for any idea. Just thinking of you, get well, see you soon, missing you. It's just a lovely idea. Instead of emails and texts, to send cards. That's just my idea. And take on things and bring back the old-fashioned way in a new modern idea. Have a nice day and a great weekend. Bye-bye. Well, hello, everybody. This is Nikki Zick from Nikki Zick Paints. And good morning. Actually, it's 5:45 where I'm broadcasting from. And I had this wild idea this morning while having my coffee. Still about the cat's tongue brush, but doing a minimalist gift card. And here I am. It's not really a gift card, it's a postcard, but just by using the cat's tongue brush in three different sizes in three different colors, what a wonderful, I think, card that is. So it takes a little patience because you have to wait for each color to dry so that there's no bleeding. As you can see closely, everything was dry. I first did the large pinwheel using my largest cat's tongue brush, a number 10 for the largest. Then I used a number 6 for the medium size. And then I went all the way down to a number 2 for the smallest. So, and as you can also hear, I'm listening to some nice smooth jazz. So as I was doing each pinwheel, it's, as you see, the movement is really nice and graceful because I was doing it to the sound of the music. So I'm just going to start off with the large circle because, like I said, we need time for the others to dry. But as you can see, all you do is just overlap slightly. The middle I overlap more, and then the smallest I just did in the corner. And it has this graceful composition of a beautiful 5x7 card. I have envelopes that I sell, bunches of 10 cards, 10 envelopes. On my Etsy shop, Fresh Paint at Nikki Z. But this has nothing to do with that. This is just my own personal card that I'm going to give to someone special. So let's get to painting. So I'm going to prop this up over here, just so you could look at it and I could look at it while I paint. And I'm going to do it in the same colors because, of course, I did them in pink and purple. My favorite. Let's start with my relaxed rock. Come on, relax, help out. Okay, this brush, I never used it before. It's quite large, and I was wondering how I was going to fit it in my little pans over here, but it worked. And as you can see, I wet my brush first and then went right into the light pink, and you just load up your brush and make sure you load it well. And actually, you don't even want to load it too much because the paint absorbs into the bristles of the brush. So you dab off, and now I start into the center, upper, middle to upper left corner. So I start in the center, gradually go around, and I was turning my brush and down and lift, turn and down and lift, lift. Then I load more paint, went into backwards, you hear the nice music in the background, and just go with the tone. Paint's getting a little dry. Load up some more paint. Go back. Go tend on the edge. If you want to make it even larger, I need more paint. If I want to go even larger, this background. Picked up a little orange in my pan, because like I said, this brush is large. Go back. Okay, I think that's good for this large pinwheel. And then I'll make a part two and then go into the small second size, whoops, using my number six brush. I'm going to do the hot pink pinwheel. So I'm going to take a break now, drink a sip of coffee, and come back and we'll do the second size middle pinwheel. Thank you.